If you are looking at selling your home, can you sell it as is? Do you need to make updates? Let's talk about the types of buyers that are out there looking for homes. Hi, I'm Karen Goodman with Circa Properties, and today let's talk about the four types of buyers that are out there in the market looking for homes in St. Louis. They go everything from flips to as-is homes, but the type of buyer that you are attracting of these four types of buyers is going to make a big difference in what you can price your home. So first, let's talk about the flip buyer. That buyer is looking for a perfect home. It's gorgeous. It's got granite counters and it's got subway tile, at least right now. And it's got beautiful paint that is the trendy color, and the floors are trendy, and the yard is beautiful, and everything is done. And that buyer is totally willing to pay top dollar because they are buying a gorgeous home. It's probably professionally staged. They walk in and they just feel so good about it and they want that house. That's our top dollar buyer. On the other end of the spectrum, our buyer number four is our buyer that is looking for a house that is a steal. They are willing to do everything. They are willing to gut the kitchen and gut the bathrooms and fix the foundation problem and deal with the water leak. They are fine with anything, but they want the house really cheap. That is usually an investor. The owner-occupant buyer just doesn't have the money to fix all those things. And they don't really want to take on that level of work most of the time. Occasionally you can find somebody, but even if you do, the price they're going to pay for contractors is probably not as good as the price the investor would have paid. So their cost for the work is a little higher, but they don't need the profit versus the investor whose cost of the work is cheaper, but they do need the profit. It usually comes out pretty close to the same. So on the two ends of the spectrum, you've got flip, top dollar, as is, needs tons of work, cheap. Buyer number two, right under the flip buyer, is the person that they don't need to be perfect. They are willing to change out like the kitchen faucet, and they are willing to fix that little piece of trim that's missing. And maybe even change the style of the doors because, you know, your house has old 1970s doors that were brown that you now painted white, and they really want this like really good wood doors. They're willing to do this kind of work. They are not willing to redo the kitchen. They are not willing to redo all the bathrooms, but they can do a few things, but they want the house cheaper because it is not a flip completely. There are things they still need to do. Our last buyer that I want to talk about is the buyer that is actually really okay with a house that's dated, that hasn't been updated in 20 or 30 years. Maybe it's got original kitchens, maybe it's got original vanities, but it's in really good condition. The challenge is figuring out if you're willing to do updates, are you willing to get it all the way to the top dollar of getting it perfect, like a flip? Or do you want to get just a little bit short of that, but then price it enough below the flip price to make it worth the buyer's while? This is where I feel like a lot of people are not realistic. They think that their house is completely okay, but the buyers out there feel like it really needs to be updated and feel like it's too expensive given the fact that things haven't been updated. So if you have a home to sell, I would love to talk with you about where you fall in that range. I work with people that are selling all four of those types of home. I work with buyers that are looking for all four types of homes. It's just a matter of making sure you are matching buyers' expectations. So that's all for today. I will see you soon.